Have you ever opened a book to see a gorgeous image spread out across two pages, whether it was a fantastical map or the scene setting for an individual chapter? If you wondered how you could get the same effect for your book, you're in the right place. This tutorial will guide you through every step one by one so you can accomplish this two-page spread using Atticus. In this tutorial, we'll cover two methods. First, we'll create a two-page spread using a map or two separate full-page images. Then we'll explore how to combine the image on the right side of the page with the text of a new chapter. Ready to enhance your book's visual appeal? Let's get started. Atticus is not a graphics editing program, so you will need to start with images that are perfectly sized. To help, we have an image size calculator linked in the description box below this video that will help you calculate the size you need to match your book's trim and bleed specifications. If you're doing your own artwork using BookBrush, Photoshop, Canva, or another similar graphics program, you will need to create two images that match the single page trim size. Be sure to align the images to meet precisely in the middle. You will need two separate images, to be clear, one for the left side of your book and one for the right side. Once you have your images ready, open your book in Atticus. To add two separate full page images so they appear side by side in a spread when you open the book, start by clicking the three dots beside the Add a Chapter button and select Full Page Image. Drag and drop it where you'd like it to appear in your book. Add a second full page image and place it directly below the first. Change the title of each page so you can quickly tell them apart in the left navigation panel. Click the three dots beside the title of the left image and set it to Begin On Left Side. Do the same for the right image, but set it to Begin On Right Side. If you want to have an image spread showing each chapter in your book with the first page of your chapter's content written on top of the background image on the right side of the page, you'll need to do this in two steps. First, insert the left page image as before. Add a full page image, place it before the chapter, and ensure it's set to begin on the left. For the very first chapter in your book, the left image will need to be placed in the front matter section. This is because the first page in the body section will always begin on the right side of your book. For all remaining chapters, place the left side image between each chapter. To set the background image for your chapter page to appear on the right, you will need to adjust your theme settings. Click Formatting from the top center, select your theme, click the three dots to edit. From the chapter heading section, scroll down the page to adjust the image settings. Choose background image for your chapter. If you are repeating the same image throughout your entire book, upload it here. Ensure you enable full bleed and adjust the opacity and text settings. If you'll be using a different image for every chapter, toggle on individual chapter images. Save your theme. For individual images, return to each chapter and upload the image using the link by the chapter title. If you enable light text in your theme settings so you can use a dark background image, the first page of every chapter in your book will be set to have white text. If you're using individual chapter images and some pages use a light background image, you can click the gear icon beside the chapter title and invert text color. This is also handy for chapters or pages that don't use a background image at all, like your author page, for example. In Atticus, you can open the previewer by clicking the icon at the bottom right. It's important to note that ebooks are not able to display images to the very edges of a screen, so there will always be a border. They also cannot place a background image behind the body content, so your image will only appear in the header portion of each chapter. If you look above the previewer, you can change the default view from iPad to print to see what each page will look like in a PDF view. If you want to see a two-page spread, you can export your PDF to flip through the full book. To view spreads, two pages side by side, using Adobe Acrobat Reader, you'll have to adjust a few settings to ensure it shows you the layout as it would be in a physical book rather than a digital document. Here's how. Open your PDF, click View or Menu from the top menu, navigate to where it says Page Display, and select either Two-Page View or Two-Page Scrolling. Make sure you select Show Cover Page in the Two-Page View for a complete preview. This will ensure all your pages appear in the correct side of the spread as they will in the printed version of your book. One quick way to confirm that all the pages are on the right side is to look at the page numbers. Odd pages will always appear on the right side of your book, and even numbered pages will always begin on the left side. Now you have the ability to add two-page spreads to all of your books in a variety of ways, whatever works best for your content. If you found this tutorial helpful, please do give it a thumbs up, and I also recommend you subscribe to our channel. You may also want to hit the notifications bell in the corner there so you are always updated as soon as we release a brand new demo, tutorial, or any kind of video content for you. As always, on behalf of the entire Atticus team, we wish you happy writing, formatting, and most of all, publishing.